Hello everyone, welcome to The Joy of Building. This series we aim to bring the joy in your life by building in City Skylines. We aim to teach you how easy it is to build cities and enjoy them. So let's just get into it, I guess. In this series, we're going to build the city of St. Anthony. The first step is always to place your very first district. Very important to do this. If you have special building settings you like to turn on for thematical purposes or city functions, it's important to have them laid in now, as to not disrupt your gameplay and further down the road there. Just remember, the key is not to stress. Never to stress. We're going to just call this St. Anthony. And then we're going to set European suburbia and a few policies as well. I'm just going to quickly set up all the water and sewage requirements. It's important to do this first, as you do have a limited amount of money. Always important to place your intake upstream from your your outflow. And then we'll just directly connect these. No stress. Absolutely no stress. All right. Now, just gonna wait for the game to stop lagging. And then we're going to delete these first segments here. And we're going to start off by building just a straight dirt road out this long. Nothing crazy. Nothing crazy. And we're just going to connect the highway in. Now we need to get power set up. Just put that over here. Now we do have everything available to us, but I think we'll just start with a couple coal plants. Just connect everything up here now. We're not getting fancy here, we're just trying to get the bones of our city, our town laid out. Nothing too crazy. Now, it's important to remember, this now is our main road going along here. So when zoning on it, we want to reduce the amount of traffic that has to turn on and off this road. Just want to kind of minimize this road to straight through traffic and traffic that wants to access the immediate buildings on this road. So in doing that, we're going to build side roads that follow along the main road here. We'll do that on both sides of the road. Now, you don't have to do this. I mean, you'll find your own way of building. This is just the way I like to do things. It helps keep traffic flowing. and later down the road, the line, when you have to build more elaborate junctions down here, you can actually convert these to one-way roads, allowing for better traffic control. Anyways, the second step here is we're going to now build our subdivisions. This is a typical way of easily building out cities so that you don't have to overplan your highway network too much anyways. Mostly just have to follow terrain and topography and stuff like that. So the easiest way to do this is to just use the construction cost. You'll notice many people do this. I want to build 1,000 dollar subdivisions. So this one here is 175, so we need 825 to complete the block. And then 1,000. So now, these will be the only access points off this road to access these communities back here. We'll add no more junctions in this area. From here to here, there'll be no more roads on or off. That is the way it's going to be. So I'm just going to build out a few of these blocks so we can get ready for laying the foundations of our city. So now we've got a good start to our grid here. Give us a good little idea of where things should go. So we'll now plan our very first community here. First homes. Nothing too crazy. As always, no stress. No stress. There's really no right way to do any of this stuff. Whatever you end up doing, we'll just change the way the game works, and you just have to work with it. There's really no right way. You just have to learn how to do your own style. This is just the way I like to do things. No right way. No right way. So this is also kind of going to be a main road. So I almost think, and I also want to plan to get this to work in this way as well. Maybe what we'll do here is plan this highway actually that we're going to put through here. Because I know I do want to hook that up through this. That. So when we do have the ability to buy all that stuff, we can hook all that up. That was just so we could figure out where we're going to put our back road here, so that we can bring that through. so we can finish planning this community. Just like that. Nothing crazy. Nothing too crazy. Now in some of these places, we're going to want to put pathing, or you could put fencing, whatever you'd like, just to force the zoning. In the center of these blocks that are just a little tight. And here as well. Because there's going to be homes on the back side here, and businesses probably on the front here. Excuse me. Now we also want to build a side road system here. This is also going to be a main road now. Put that connection out. And like that. We'll run up on this side too, but we don't need to go that far. So now I think we can zone our first few homes right here. And just get the power to them. Make sure it doesn't really get that there. And the water. Then we'll run the simulation and start people moving in. Real simple. Nothing crazy. We have no plans for the immediate, the far future. We're just focused on what the city needs right now. Focused on getting us into the green. Nothing crazy here. Nothing crazy. We're going to leave probably this section here undeveloped for the time being. And I think what I want to do here is connect these two roads. This road like that, and then like that. And then here, I'm going to pause the simulation for just a half a second. Yeah. Make sure that no housing will be zoned on this side of the street. After that point. Yeah. So we need a bit of commercial demand now to fill. We'll build that right in here. Just like that. Guess we'll get it up on both sides here. Might as well. Get a couple more homes back here. I'm gonna check that covers everything. I have no plans on building any specialized industry on this island. So no farms or anything. Even though there's farmland here, that's not gonna be turned into farms. This is just gonna be built over. Sadly. But realistically. We'll get a base station down now, just a small one. Maybe get it back here. And a fire station as well. Probably won't hurt to get a dump over here. Incinerator to just help. The clinic. Guess right there will be fine. Put a cemetery down there. An attached crematorium. That would just save him. That should get us through the foreseeable future for most services and amenities. That way we're not stressing out. Just easy. So we got a big demand for residential now. We'll just fill up the rest of these blocks here that we set ourselves up with. Commercial and residential area here. So we get commercial here. Never mind. Made a mistake there. That still works out alright though. That's for the commercial. I mean residential area, but the commercial. So this was right. Commercial there. There we go. That should get us through. We're gonna have to save our budget by turning down some of these services. So roads, even though it's not huge, garbage will cut in half. But we're not using it to its full capacity yet. So same for all these. That should save us some money. No stress though. No stress. We are playing with realistic population mod on. Maybe I'll get some road back here, getting ready for industry. I think it's important maybe that we also buy this tile right here. And I'm gonna demo all of this highway garbage. We don't want any of it. We're gonna replace it just with a simple road, dirt road. For now, and on this side, we're going to build some farm, industrials farm. So our subdivisions are 1,000, so we want to offset our subdivides from the main road this way here. Now we can get some farmland in here. I'm going to check the size of these farms, so I make sure I put the road in the right spot here. Oops. Screen moved. So I'm just, just to cause a problem. So we're just holding our finger here to keep a measure of where that is. And if we did it right, still be able to fit in there. Perfect. So we'll place down our homestead. So, you're gonna be that way again. That really makes sense here. We're just using our finger to measure where we need it. That way we get it where we want it, so we don't have to spend money to keep moving it 1,000 times. You just put your finger on the screen, measure tool 1.0. No stress here. Oh, well, we still messed it up. Oh well, life continues. Put that in there. It did work out. Look at that. And get a grain silo. Yeah. Change all this to wheat. Yeah, might as well. Very easy, no stress. That's the key here. The key is to not stress. We got our first wheat farm. Well, we need some water, I guess, some power over here. We'll bring that right across. Power line. Like that. Still seems to want more resource laid down here. Well, we'll give it what it wants. I'll have to bleed a few trees. Fix that. Fix that. That should start generating us some revenue. Empty. Actually, I think we'll keep that on balanced for now. Keep it on balanced. We'll probably put a ton of farmland in here. This will eventually not be industry. We'll have specialized industry probably here. I don't know. Nothing too crazy. Nothing too crazy. We have a huge demand for residential now, so we'll fill that out. Probably relatively quick. Forgot to add water. That's alright. No mistakes. There's no mistakes. Just happy accidents. Commercial developing quite nicely over here. Just get a little bit more in there. Fill up the rest of this as well. Why not? Real easy. I've made this mistake in the past. Hooked it into the side road there. That's an easy fix. I do that all the time when I'm building new cities. But you know what? Add a little character. And like a little detail there. No problems, no problems. No mistakes, just happy accidents. Now that's gonna mean this grid off from this grid. Perfectly fine. In fact, it'll create a much better look at the end of the day. when the grids are separate and different. No stress. Absolutely no stress. I'm just building this nice little park here, you know, nothing too crazy, just having a little fill-in piece, you could say, to this corner unit that wasn't going to fit homes very well. There was no sense in trying to fit them. As we can put in here. Nothing crazy. No plan. No plan. Just placing it down. Not stressing, not caring. Just doing that. So now over here, I think because we've managed to put, you know, industry here, we're going to build this out as if it were a main street. We're going to build a side road. Connecting like that. We can now put a buffer of commercial here before we put our residential in now. Just like that. No stress, no stress. And we'll just put our little down the middle. Easy. Pause the simulation for a minute. Put some residential on this side. We're going to use the fences again here to block in the center of these more closer blocks. It's just to get a better even distribution of houses. That way you don't get like a 4 house here and then like a 3 house here. It's to make sure that your houses are evenly distributed around the block. Makes for a more balanced look. Now I'm not saying you have to do it that way. It's just the way I like to do things. Makes it look the way I'm going for it anyways. I have to get water down the rest of this street and then connect in our new residential units here. Just like that. So we're going to go back into our district's settings here, district view, and we're going to remove the district from the main roads here. Oop. Of course, we get an autosave right in the middle of doing this. Now, what this is going to do is interact with the policy that stops cars from heavy traffic ban. That's it. The heavy traffic ban is going to interact with that. And it means that there's not going to be any cars that will go through the center of these neighborhoods. Or ideally, they shouldn't, anyways. Cars should prioritize. Should only be able to use this road if they're going through the city or around the city or town, whatever you want to call it. Just like that. So now these through roads here, for example, this one here will not be prioritized by anybody other than people using this to get to their homes or to businesses. From their homes to a business or from a business to their home. There's not going to be any commercial trucks going through these areas, ideally. We'll start the simulation again. Same with here. No commercial trucks. And this will be even more crucial once we get this hooked into the highway here. Got a little fire there. So we're in bankruptcy here because we can't manage to get ourselves into a positive. We are profiting here. So what we'll do is we will take a loan, offset our costs, and I think we'll increase taxes now to 12%, should be good. And now this should offset everything. We should see positive income here in a second. Oh, and budgets. Yeah, we can cut probably the power down in half to the water down just a little bit. So we're going to need another loan, take this loan, pay that one, and then here we can get a flour mill, just to start producing an export. Beside it, this will be for We should start producing income now. So I think that's where we'll leave this episode. And we'll see you next time. Bye.